I sing Seven Nation Army from my blind audition. One of the reasons that I decided to sing that song was because I thought that it was a very good way to introduce myself to the coaches and reintroduce myself to America, kind of as like a rock soul guy. You know, I'm a black guy that loves to rock out, and I thought that Seven Nation Army was just a perfect way to let people know where I was coming from, my angle, and obviously it worked, so I'm glad I sang it. I've been off of meth now for 6 years, so I've had time to adjust and readjust to a life without it, and I was not pursuing music at all when I was strung out. I was just trying to be as high as possible, as much as possible. And in fact, it's really sad because, you know, I have like 5 years that are really just kind of a blur, but I'm living my best life now. I'm living my best days right now, and I'm living proof that, man, you can always turn it around. You can always turn it around. The toughest challenge in the show was singing against Jamie Lono. Before that, it had kind of been a cakewalk. Like, I just was having fun. I got to meet CeeLo, and I acted like a 12-year-old schoolgirl, like, on the stage. Jamie and I became friends before we auditioned for the blind auditions. In fact, I don't know if he'll kill me for saying this, but, like, he would, like, freak out. But I first heard him playing guitar by the pool, and he sounded amazing. And I went to go talk to him, and he was kind of freaking out about his blind audition. And every time I would see him, I would just be like, dude, you're great. Like, I know you've heard everybody else around here that can sing. You deserve to be here, just like everyone else. And so then when he made a team, I felt like a proud dad. I really did. But then I found out he was on CeeLo's team, and then I was like, So then when we had to battle each other, I will say that that was the most emotionally draining. Because I really respect him. I like him as a person, more than just an artist. I like him as a person. And that win was bittersweet. It was a bittersweet win. I have not touched perfect, but I will say that I did pass by Miss Perfect as she was having a photo shoot with champagne. And I was struck with jealousy at that moment. I said, damn, this cat lives better than I do. Literally, there were like 10 people around. She had a handler, she had someone like dangling a toy, and somebody else saying, hey, you're perfect, right here. And I was like, really? Are you kidding me, really? She has more followers on Twitter than I do. It's crazy to me.